Okay, magandang umaga po or magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. Salamat sa pagbisita sa aking channel. Here we talk about anything and everything about crypto. We'll give you insights, news, and sharing important events. No, this is me documenting my crypto journey, and this is not a financial advice. And always remember po that we don't need to be melodramatic dito sa pag-invest sa ganitong assets. Just be cool, no? Kalma lang tayo. Yung sakto lang. Wala po ditong magic money. If you're here for a quick buck, okay lang naman. Just make sure that you place your trades carefully at pinag-isipan nyo talaga. So, meaning, nag-technical analysis kayo. You also check sentiments, no? Yung market sentiments para sure kayo sa inyong mga trades. Then, because if you're here for, yun nga, yung quick buck, wala po kasing ganyan. If you might lose really big money pag ganun po, kasi you will be affected by a lot of emotions, or basically yung emotion baka manaig, and yung makita nyo, kung makita nyo yung mga price volatility, because it will go up and down, the price will go up and down, and baka hindi nga ninyo magustuhan. At dun madalas na tatalo po yung pumapasok sa cryptocurrency, kasi they are buying high and they are selling low, which is dapat baliktad, low and then you sell high. Okay, so remember lang po, no, to not put your life savings dito. Invest only what you can afford to lose. Crypto is still a high risk and high reward investment. Kaya importante that you are always updated. Do diligence before investing to manage risk. And syempre, I'm here. Kasama nyo rin ako in your journey. Okay, so today we have a lot of exciting news, updates, crypto adoptions, no, about crypto adoptions, big business movements. And maganda dito, even during these trying times in the market, nakakita tayo ng mga, and nakakabasa tayo ng mga big news or good news, no? At syempre, exciting at sakto nga, no? Nakabalik na si paring Jose Marie dito sa atin. Pagpasok ng bear month. Mukhang totoo yun, eh. Yung sakto, September 1, nakabalik na si Jose Marie Chan. Not sure lang. Well, siyempre, no? Opo, tama. September na. Sa crypto, ano naman kaya ang ibig sabihin ito? No? Okay, so, alright. Before anything else, let me give you a quick market recap. Okay, here's the quick market update. BTC or Bitcoin at 19,893 and 1.78% down in the last 24 hours. ETH or Ethereum, 1,542.47, down by 2.55% in the last 24 hours. We have your stablecoins, USDT, USDC, and then followed by BNB, BUSD, XRP, ADA or Cardano. So the rest ay US stablecoins, but our top 10 ay kasama dyan si Cardano, Solana, and I think pumasok si Dogecoin. Okay, highest market cap is still Bitcoin at 380,739,000,000, followed by ETH, 188,598,000. And syempre, cryptocurrency is still a billion-dollar market. And what is September nga, no, sa crypto? So, as we can see here on the Bitcoin chart, in the last 3 years, we can see a drop every September on the Bitcoin price. So, 2019, 2020, then 2021. And if you zoom in nga, no, dito sa kanila, so for example dito sa dalawa, we can see that by the way, this is on the weekly chart. We can see that after we have this this small rally here, and it will fall, at the same time here. Right. And also in this area. So may rally siya tapos bagsak. Then after September, normally nagpipick naman siya. So if I think it's a good month to buy on September. But again, no, not financial advice. Anything can happen and it might change. Who knows, 'di ba? Pwedeng magbago 'yan. And dito nga sa ating 4-hour chart, no. We're trading again at 19,854 and dito sa 4-hour chart, we can see clearly that we are getting a support, no. Support around this area. So meaning after, every time na papasok or magse-sell, pag dumaabot dito, mabalik naman. So this one katulad nito, no. This one nag-up uli siya, kaso 'yun, nakahanap ng resistance then nag-fall na naman. May fake out, nag-fall, nag-up. And currently it's trying to test din na naman tong resistance level na to. And let's see whether it will fall or it will finally conquer this bearish pattern, no? Lumabas siya dito sa triangle and probably meet this resistance. So if you're like trading, you can use this. So magbumili ka dito, then mag-stop loss ka dito. And that's your hanggang 20,800. So from 19,800 to 20,800, pwede mong gawin yan. Mag-long trade ka. But of course, you just have to wait for the confirmation. Mag-wait ka na malumabas siya sa triangle. Then you do the trade. Or you can short. Okay, so bakit nga importanteng tinitingnan yung chart ni Bitcoin, no? Kasi nga lahat yan, halos lahat ng top coins na meron sa cryptocurrency are pegged to Bitcoin. So actually, pag tinignan nyo yung chart nila, halos parehas na parehas yan. So for example, Bitcoin. Ethereum. Bitcoin, Ethereum, and then Cardano. Okay, so we are not out of the woods pa nga, no? And still we are riding this bearish market, bearish month, but we might see a little pump on other on alternate coins like Ethereum and Cardano because of their upcoming upgrades. So for Ethereum, it's the merge. As they estimated, it might happen mga September 15. And pwedeng magkasabay sila ni Cardano because around that date din sila pwedeng mag-release ng update. Actually, for Cardano, they are just waiting for exchanges to upgrade so that they can push na with the Vasil upgrade niya. But again, if Vasil will come na, it might trigger a little spike on the ADA's price or Cardano's price, like what happened to previous upgrade, like here in Shelly, yung nag-upgrade sila kay Shelly, then doon kay Mary, and then Alonzo. However, all this happened ng I think bull run or bull market, unlike kay Vasil ngayon na nasa bear market. But from the current price of 0.4450, we can expect at least a little pump. I'm not expecting a lot, so some are expecting at least $2, but I think it will only push through hanggang around 0.80 or 0.90 because it will get a resistance around this area. So kasi may resistance dito na sa 0.7720 hanggang 0.80. So your coin can go there hanggang probably until 0.80, and then it will go back again. So like this one, no? So nangyari dito and dito. So mag-up yung 0.80 and bababa. Alright, so time for some updates. Here we go. Ito, isa sa mga paborito natin, tahimik lang na crypto, pero grabe gumalaw. Okay, Vechain, no? Vechain, another bugs, another partnership. And this time, it enters new partnership with Canadian product verification software company. And tinignan ko kung sino to. This is on their official Twitter page, but it was also announced by their partner on its own Twitter and website. Now, Vechain on its official Twitter account on Monday disclosed that it has partnered with Canadian software firm TrueTrace to improve blockchain adoption in product provenance and authentication. So, sabi ni Vechain, we are excited to announce a strategic integration partnership with TrueTrace Technologies, a Canadian SaaS platform that will soon offer Vechain toolchain to clients. Together, we're accelerating blockchain adoption for provenance and authentication, Vechain wrote in its tweet. No? Now, sino ba si TrueTrace, mga kaibigan? No? Si TrueTrace po is a software as a service SaaS company that provides blockchain integrated software for legal cannabis, food, apparel, and pharmaceutical industries. Notably, TrueTrace software can be used to demystify the supply chain process in all of these industries. So, meaning to demystify is ayusin, linisin, centered on quality, integrity, and efficiency nung output. So ganun po yung kagaling si TrueTrace, and I think they are big in Canada. Hindi naman si Tataga Canada, but they are big in Canada, guys. And they are partnered with different business industries in Canada, and they're the one providing yung software service for these companies. And TrueTrace believes that integrating Vechain's enterprise blockchain technology will improve the system's transparency, protecting users from adulterated products. TrueTrace believes that this is true and very much needed in the legal cannabis sector, which it considers its primary focus. Alright, so tinignan ko itong TrueTrace, hinahanap ko yung kanilang website, and this is what I saw. So, very clean website, at ito nga, nakalagay sa website nila, no? TrueTrace is the new standard in product verification. Okay, how can you know the products you sell are not being counterfeited? How can the customer verify that your product is safe from harmful chemicals and heavy metals? No, product quality testing, validation, and verification is why TrueTrace was created. We uniquely combine blockchain with business operations to connect customers, distributors, and regulatory entities with the insights they need on products across all industries where it's needed the most, ranging from food and cosmetics to pharmaceuticals and cannabis. Okay, so para sa akin, it's a big partnership. Again, another B2B business deal para kay Vechain, no? And I actually checked one of TrueTrace partners, no? Ito pa lang si Shoppers Drug ng Canada ay partner nila, no? And ito nga, way back 2019, which hanggang ngayon is partnered with TrueTrace to help guarantee product and quality and genetics from genome to patient. Okay, Shoppers Drug Mart is partnering with TrueTrace Technologies to bolster its medical cannabis retail platform. The Vancouver-based company's blockchain-based software is designed to guarantee product quality and genetics throughout supply chain from genome to patient. Ginugil ko lang, no? Shoppers Drug Mart. Ito yung nakita ko. So, Shoppers Drug Mart. Shoppers Drug Mart Inc. is a Canadian retail pharmacy chain based in Toronto, Ontario. It has more than 1,300 stores in 9 provinces and 2 territories. So yun, so ganun siya kalaki, kalaking business establishment that was partnered with TrueTrace, and now TrueTrace is partnered with Vechain. And ayun nga, no, si at yun nga si Vechain, in fact, just bag partnership with UFC, with somehow partnered with Amazon, and then partnered with Orion One ng US, that's a logistic company. And now ito na naman si TrueTrace naman. And it's really a bullish news for Vechain holders, no? Well, I have Vechain because even not hearing this news pa, meron na ako kasi parang ewan ko, parang kakaiba yung tunog eh. So Vechain, parang medyo macho yung tunog niya, kaya sabi ko parang okay ito, kaya bumili ako, kaya nagdag ako sa portfolio ng Vechain. Baka iniisip ko baka someday, 'di ba, partnered with UFC and probably will be partnering with other sports. And ayun nga, so ngayon it, and actually tina-target din pala nila NFTs, metaverse. So I think it's a, this is there's a possibility that this coin or crypto can 10x in the next bull run. So again, this is not a financial advice. I'm not paid by this Vechain. Hindi nila ako kilala, hindi ko sila kilala. And you know, bago lang naman tong channel natin. I'm just sharing my insights. I'm just sharing my view on this. And you, and maganda dito, no? And maganda nga dito, no? Uy, na-fulfill na pala tong order ko na Vechain. Anyway, no, maganda nga dito yung price niya. Kita nyo, 0.02392. And if you have like 1,000 pesos, diba, that natutulugan mo lang and hindi mo papansinin after 10 years mo nababalikan, this is yung 1,000 mo, which is currently $17 ngayon, which is equivalent to 17 BUSD. It will give you 710 Vechain. Okay, so 710. So let's say, no, siyempre tumaas yung, kumari, tumaas yung presyo niyan. Kumari lang naman, no? Well, naging sabihin mo na very very conservative na nga to eh. Sa bull run naging $1 siya. So your $17 will be $710. Diba? And how much is that? $710. Kumpitin nyo po yan. So again, di ako paid ng mga to. Sinasabi ko lang, just sharing my insights. Diba? Sharing my view on this. And yung kung 1,000 nyo, kinumpit ko na, no? Parang ang equivalent ng $710 is around the 39,000 to 40,000 pesos. So yun, siyempre hindi ko naman sinasabi sa inyo na bumili kayo ngayon. Sinasabi ko lang, kino-compare ko lang, I'm just giving again my opinion on this coin that can possibly give you like a 10x in the future. yung 1K mo naging ganun. So, it's not a financial advice actually. No. Just nagkumpit lang ako dito, pinakita ko lang sa inyo what will happen and what can happen if nag $1 si Vechain. Only if nag $1 si Vechain. Napaka-conservative nga nun kasi $1. Imagine. At this low price. So, yun lang po. No? Nag-share lang ako sa inyo. Pero alam nyo, naging interesado ako. Eh. Paano kaya pag nag-10x, kumpitin natin? Paano kung nag-$10 siya? So, it will give you 7,107. So, kukumpitin ko. No? 7,107 times 56. So, it will give you 397,000. Yung 1K mo naging 300. And that's probably around, probably 5 years from now. Okay, so we're anticipating a bull run sa 2024. So probably $1 by then. And then if you still have those coins, then probably another bull run. Well, who knows, no? Eh, kasi ganun lang po talaga yun sa cryptocurrency. Nakita nyo naman, no? If you haven't seen yung yung Bitcoin chart, pinakita ko nung episode na nauna dito sa crypto, then go ahead and check it. Or you can simply Google it, no? Yung price ng Bitcoin from 1. Kasi yun lang naman talaga yun, eh, yung susundan ng mga cryptos, di ba? That is if the crypto is successful. But with what is happening with Vechain and what they're securing as partners, I believe the coin has a bright future, like Cardano, Polygonmatic. No, yan po yung mga hawak kong coins na probably you can look at and research on before you invest on something. Yan, Tita. Okay. So you can check those coins. No? But this one is pretty much very good kasi nga napakababa pa. Siya ngayon napakababa pa ng presyo niya. And I'm not saying that it cannot go down kasi baka mamaya bumili kayo ngayon. Tapos bukas naging nakita nyo, naging 0.21, diba? Yun talaga, bumababa siya. Pero may time din bumaba. Katulad po nito dito. Pakita ko sa inyo, if bumili ka kung wari dito, diba? Bumili ka dito, 0.15, bumaba siya ng 0.08. tapos bumalik naman siya ng 0.18. So dapat dito nag-sell ka na ng coin mo kasi bumaba pa siya. So meaning po volatile po talaga 'yan. Kaya nga po dinetrade, kaya nga po kasama siya sa trading, kasama siya sa cryptocurrency kasi nga 'yan, kasi nga may tendency siya to go up and down. And since we are on the bear market, it will there's really a chance na bumaba siya. Now it's up to you whether to wait for the coin to go lower para bago kayo bumili so that you can maximize your capital, or you can buy now kung wala ka naman pakialam sa 1K mo, then tulugan mo after 10 years pagising mo. Who knows, you can check, probably may nangyari, probably wala. So that's fine. It's part of the game. It's part of being here in this world, in this cryptocurrency world. Okay. So, let's go to another news. Alright, so yun nga. This one is also a bullish news from Cardano. Dumating na ang decentralized lending from sa Cardano blockchain, and that's Ada Finance. Ada Finance launches first lending and borrowing app on Cardano mainnet, and it will launch on September 13. Okay po. So kaya ngayon tong Ada Finance, nakita niyo po dito. So yung Ada Finance sa coin market cap, no, 7.17% up the last 24 hours, and ang price niya is 0.7412. Now, ang price niyan, nanggaling po siya sa 0.66. Just yesterday, 0.66 siya. Ngayon, 0.74, and I think there's a chance na mag $1 to. not a financial advice, just mag-research mo, research muna bago kayo pumasok. But I'm just thinking na baka nga ganun, no? May chance na mag $1 more than that, kasi masyadong bullish yung mga tao about Ada Finance, since this is the first from Cardano, and it will be launching on September 13. So most likely yung mga Cardano holders din yan, bullish sila dyan, or kung sino pang pumapasok dito sa crypto ni Ada Finance, whoever's holding it, whoever's buying it. So probably maganda yung outlook nila dito about this Ada Finance, since this is the very first from a very first lending and ng Cardano, and be launching on September 13. Okay, maraming salamat po sa pagsama niyo sa akin ngayong araw na to, and hopefully you can join me again on the next video. Kung tingin niyo may napulot kayo na kahit paano information, and you like the content, please drop a like, put a little comment there, and if you can share, of course I will appreciate it. See you again next time. Bye for now.